Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, today we'll learn how to find out the missing details in cost sheet by preparing the format of cost sheet and having the alertness to know the missing details. From the following information, prepare cost sheet for the month of December 2014. Stock on hand, 1st December 2014. We have opening stock of raw material. It will be added to direct materials. Work in progress. It will be added to gross works cost. Finished goods. It is added to cost of production. Raw material consumed during the month December 2014, total amount is given 21,800. Usually this information is not given in the question when opening stock and closing stock details are given. So as this information is given purposely, that means we are required to find out some missing information relating to direct materials. Works cost for the month, after adjusting work in progress, 48,400. Information of net works cost is given, which is usually not given in the question. This also shows that we are required to find out some balancing information. Cost of goods sold is given, which is usually not given in the question. That also suggests that we are required to find out some information which is usually given but not given in this question. Purchase of raw materials, direct material, carriage on purchases, direct material, sale of finished goods, sales is given, direct wages, sale of finished goods, sales, direct wages, direct labor, direct expenses, it will be part of prime cost, factory overheads, administration overheads, selling overheads. Let us start with the cost sheet. We are required to complete first format year to get the missing information. First, we are required to consider direct material. Opening stock of raw material is given 25,000. Raw material consumed during the period is given 21,800. And here we have purchase of raw material 21,900. Opening stock of raw materials we have 25,000. Purchase of raw material is given 21,900. Carriage on purchases is given 1,100. We have to deduct the value of closing stock of raw material from this total. This total is 48,000, but we don't have information of closing stock of raw material. So that we'll require to find out as balancing figure. Raw material consumed during the period is 21,800. Direct material consumption 21,800. Now from this total 48,000, If I deduct closing stock of raw material, I should get this 21,800. So I will get this as what? Balancing figure. From 48,000 we'll deduct 21,800. So we got closing stock of raw material as a balancing figure, which was a missing amount, 26,200. Next, we have to record direct labor. Direct labor, direct wages is 17,200. Next, we have to record direct expenses, given 1200. We can add all these expenses, including direct expense 1200, to arrive at prime cost. It is 40,200. To this, we are required to add factory overheads. Factory overheads is given 9,100. Gross works cost we got 49,300. To the amount of gross works cost, we are required to add opening stock of work in progress. We have to deduct closing stock of work in progress so that we can get net works cost or factory cost. We have opening work in progress 8,200. And we have works cost for the month after adjusting work in progress 48,400. If we add opening work in progress, we get 57,500. Factory cost is given in the question 48,400. From this value, we are required to deduct the amount of closing work in progress so that we can get 48,400. So here work in progress will be getting as balancing figure. From the value 57,500, we have to deduct 48,400. So we got missing information, closing work in progress 9,100. To the amount of net works cost, we have to add office and administration overheads. It is given rupees 3,200. We got cost of production 51,600. To this we have to add opening stock of finished goods. Opening stock of finished goods is given 17,300. Closing stock of finished goods, we have to subtract from this so that we'll arrive at cost of goods sold. Cost of production of goods sold, they have given 53,200. So closing stock of finished goods we get here as a balancing figure. 15,700. To amount of cost of goods sold, we are required to add selling overheads. Selling and distribution overheads are 4,200. Total cost we got 57,400. To this we are going to add profit. Finally, we'll arrive at figure of sales. In question itself, they have given amount of sales. Sale of finished goods, 72,300. Now we can get profit as a balancing figure. It is 14,900. Thus, in this question, when there was a missing information, we could have found out by preparation of proper format only. While reading the question, some unusual information comes, then we are required to get alert that there is some missing information which we are required to find out. Thanks for watching this video. Stay in tune with Ikeda and subscribe to our channel Ikeda. Thank you.